Hi everyone, this is Don from Loqheart. Welcome back. In our previous video, I showed you how we took a Flash FLA and prepared it for export into Spriteloq. Here we have the individual animations exported as SWIFTs. I'm going to take these and load them into Spriteloq to show you how to align all of the animations so that when they appear inside of Corona, they are all lined up properly. Here I have the bomber walk animation selected, and its settings appear in the controls panel. I'm going to quickly set the loop options to loop and leave all of the other animations to play once. So the first thing I want to do is set the reference point for our guide. And to do that, I'm going to use the bomber walk animation's first frame. So I'm going to stop the playback by clicking the play toggle button and then jumping to the first frame. Now I'm going to click the align reference button and I'm going to position our green cursor where we want our purple cursor to appear. Somewhere near the bottom middle of a character. There. I clicked and we have set our reference point and it's been updated here in our reference point controls. The next thing I want to do is set up the reference points for all of the other animations with respect to the walk animation. So to do that, I'm going to set the walk animation as a guide by clicking the Set as Guide checkbox. And now I'm going to modify the reference points for each of the other animations one by one. I'm going to pause, jump to an appropriate frame, and then click the Align Reference button again. But this time, when I do that, notice my cursor has a shadow or a guide over our cursor. So I'm going to position that with the mouse over the Transform Red animation, and I'm going to adjust things with the keyboard slightly. So I can use the up, down, left, and right keys to position everything, and then press the space bar in order to set the reference point. And I'm going to continue doing this for all the other animations, using the mouse to get pretty close, and then using the arrow keys to align things perfectly. Now, for the explosion, I'm not going to jump to the first frame. Instead, I'm going to jump into maybe the fifth or sixth frame because I want to align this guy right in the middle of the explosion. And the first frame was a little too small to do that. So that looks about right. And so there you have it. We have all the reference points set up for our animations. Now I'm going to select all of them, pack them, and produce our sprite sheet. I'm going to call this bomber sheet. And so there you have it. We have all of our animations aligned, their loop options set up properly, and we have exported them as a sprite sheet. In the next video, I'll show you how to take this sprite sheet and display the animations on screen. Thanks for watching.